Hey guys, Michael here. I've been sitting outside waiting for UPS truck to show up because they're supposed to be bringing a box of a book set that Liz and I ordered for her. They said they would have it here by 9:30 this morning or 10:30 this morning. It's almost 11. They still aren't here. But no doubt while I'm doing this, they'll probably show up. Not a problem. I can always pause or stop it. But while I was there, this big old fat giant box was delivered to my into my hands by our local postman. And it's a box of VKLT from Mr. Matt Sands. I have not opened this. I have no idea what's in here. So my responses are going to be completely straightforward, honest, and unacted. Oh, no, I'm kidding. Susie Lewis, thank you so much. Steppenwolf, Born to be Wild. Pretty cool. Steppenwolf is not one of my favorite bands from that era, but a band that definitely is iconic, and that is an album that I do not have and that I am very, very pleased to have. Joni Mitchell, Court and Spark. Great album. I do have this. I'll see which copy I like better, and then the other one I will pass on to someone. I'm sure somebody doesn't have it. And thank you. By the way, my favorite Joni Mitchell album, personally. Wow. Okay, it's in rough shape on the sleeve, but did we talk about this? Because this, I had never heard of this. Oh my God, the album is gorgeous looking. A little bit of kind of a funky thing that happens in storage, but doesn't affect playback, just makes them look. I'm thrilled, totally thrilled. Wow, man, thank you. Totally awesome, awesome. Oh my God. I've been wanting this forever. Several people have told me they had it, they'd send it to me, blah, 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 or give it to me. I'm not talking necessarily about people in the VC. And here it is. The iconic Blue Cheer album, the one that as a kid we played utterly to death, and that I'm not going to say that this is great musicianship. Dr. Please is one of the most interesting songs of its time, and the coda at the end of it is almost hilarious. It's like these guys grabbed a tiger by the tail and they don't know how the hell to let go of it, you know. It just goes on and on. It's a fantastic record, and I can't wait to put it on. Matt, my God, total, I mean, this is just a box of grails. I am blown away. To iColumbia, the United States of America. Oh, and, you know, I have not played this album for decades. I did not own it, but a friend of mine, Randy and Penny, I'm trying to remember what their last names were. They were college students when I was in high school, and Guy Michael and I used to go over there all the time, take Dexies and smoke pot, and this was an album we played the living hell out of. Totally blown away to have the absolute. My God, there. Oh, it's just. Oh, one of the great albums by Elton John. Fantastic, beautiful. I am so blown away. What's that? Okay, I thought maybe the truck. Ah, Tom Rush. I really dig Tom Rush. And in particular, there's a song he did, and I can never remember the album it's on, but it was called Kids These Days. There it is! These Days. No, that's a different album. That's a different song. That's These Days. which I think was written by Jackson Brown. But Tom Rush is really good. One of those, you know, I mean, there were so many of those kind of folky, more Tom, Merrimack County. Wow. And this is the album. Kids these days don't value a dollar. Show like chewing, but they show can't swallow. Wouldn't like that. Oh my God, I remember this album so well. I'm gonna start crying. I'm old, and old men cry, you know. No, Electric Light Orchestra. Wow, fantastic. Electric Light Orchestra 2. This is just amazing. I haven't. Wow, a new world record. Electric Light Orchestra. I very much appreciate them. I've heard some. Well. I'll never mind about that, but still. Electric Light Orchestra, Face the Music. Wow, this is like pretty much everything I'll ever need by ELO. Electric Light Orchestra, Discovery. Man, good Lord. Ah, too cool. And we must have talked about some of these. Chubby Checker, Beach Party. I dig Chubby Checker. For the longest time, I thought of him as just another cheesy, you know. And then I actually got some Chubby Checker records, and the dude was much better than his usual reputation, I think. Much better. Frank Sinatra, Put Your Dreams Away, Six Eye Columbia. Frank is the man. When it comes to crooning, I don't really need any other crooner, to be honest. He makes me wet. The Concert Sinatra. Wow, yeah. On Reprise. This is like a bottomless, endless box. It's like the Widow's Cruise of Oil. Some of you may understand. Cornet. Tommy Dorsey and his orchestra with Frank Sinatra. And this particularly, although I grew up listening to these on 75, or 78s, 75s, as a kid, my parents had, at least five or six 78 RPM records of Tommy Dorsey and his orchestra featuring Frank Sinatra. I grew up listening to that stuff, played it until I'd broken every one of those old records. So, you know, more Frank Sinatra, Adventures of the Heart. Ooh, we kiss. Ooh, I think there might be tongue involved. I'm getting wet. More Frank, Back to Sorrento. Frank Sinatra is just the man, and I think it's pretty much undisputed. Didn't have the biggest range vocally, but that wasn't the point. Love Is a Kick, and boy, isn't it. That's it. Finally hit the bottom. Matt, I am so totally blown away. Every one of these records is a winnah. W-I-N-N-A-H. Oh, man. I wonder that my rather out of shape mailman. I wonder whatever happened to the other one. I had a really good looking guy, very, very fit, delivering mail for a while. And then lately, it's been this guy who huffs and puffs. Everything. This is just, my Frank Sinatra collection has just drastically multiplied. And I am very much looking forward to these. The Chubby Checker Beach Party. Absolutely. I'm so excited. All this ELO. These Tom Rush. And I'm so excited about, in particular, this Tom Rush. I remember this album, but I never owned it. But I did own this one, and I can remember where I lived when I owned it. It was one of the first houses I lived in where I actually paid rent, was not crashing in a crash pad, and playing the heck out of, in particular, that song, Honky Chateau. I'm blown away. Totally blown away. I cannot wait to play this. I've streamed this on YouTube. When was it you? I don't remember who it was. love it, love it. And how great is this? I mean, you know, this is that Suki Suki, Hoochie Coochie Man, Born to Be Wild, Your Wall's Too High, The Pusher. God damn, all the Pusher, man. What? Isn't that? Not only made my day, made my week, and I can save more money because I need to raise money so I can go down and work on that. I'm supposed to be the director of photography and filming. In other words, I'm the guy with the camera, operating the camera while Gretchen and Patches and Gretchen are recording their next album. And I really want to do that, but I need money. I'm going to lose income, and I'm going to be spending money. So I don't have to buy records for the next 2 months because it's going to take me that long just to really... half of these records at least, I'll probably have to play 20 times before I even put them away because it's so exciting to have them again after all these years. Wonderful, wonderful. Love you guys. You're all incredible. I'm just blown. My mind is blown. I think I'm gonna, wow.